Please be seated. On behalf of First Church of Christ Congregational in Bedford, I would like to welcome everybody to this Interfaith Thanksgiving service. It was about a year ago that we gathered together at First Parish, our sister church with our common roots, with a knowledge and concern that anti-Semitic graffiti was being found in schools and other places in Bedford. And we were shocked and offended and first spoke out against this act of hatred during that service. Little did we know that the graffiti in other instances would continue over the year. It is so important then that we gather here this afternoon as brothers and sisters of faith. We are reminded of that great psalm, how very good and pleasant it is when sisters and brothers live together in unity. It is like the precious oil on the head running down upon the beard of Aaron, running down over the collar of his robes. It's like the dew of Hermon, which falls on the mountain of Zion. For there the Lord ordained his blessing, life forevermore. As the Bedford Clergy Association, we knew we had to respond to all these acts of violence, and we worked fast and hard to confront the hatred that was attacking our brothers and sisters. We had to make a statement that Bedford embraces diversity and deplores and resists prejudice and discrimination in all places and at all levels. As we developed the Love Your Neighbor campaign and met continuously to see how we could promote this in our houses of worship and in our community, we have formed a deeper bond of friendship and support, giving us a deeper sense of purpose of who we are as Bedford clergy. And so here we are, brothers and sisters, living together in unity, worshiping together in unity, listening to one another, appreciating one another's traditions, and reaffirming our commitment to one another. Perhaps giving thanks is one theme that certainly penetrates all religious traditions, and that is why so many communities hold Interfaith Thanksgiving services. Today, I give thanks not just for the bounty and the harvest and blessings that surround us. I give thanks most of all for being able to dwell in unity and solidarity with my brothers and sisters who serve the spiritual needs of Bedford. Let us then give the Holy One thanks and praise with prayers and music and words of wisdom. Amen. Will you please join with me in the gathering prayer that is printed in the bulletin? Eternal source, creator of all, the one and holy God, we come together with gratitude for all your goodness and mercy towards us. Even as we call you by different names, we acknowledge together our common faith in you, the source of all good gifts. Give us that grace to be open and responsive to all the blessings that surround us. Give us eyes to see the immense beauty that penetrates all creation. Give us hearts that respond with songs of praise and acts of kindness. All praise and glory be to you, now and forevermore. Amen. Thank you.
life, shape your life, come life eternal. Shake, shake out of me all that is carnal. I'll take nimble steps, I'll be a David. I'll show Michael twice how he behaved.
Come, shake your life, come life eternal. Shake, shake out of me all that is carnal. I'll take nimble steps, I'll be a David. I'll show Michael twice how he behaved.
Come, life, shake your life, come life eternal. Shake, shake out of me all that is carnal. I'll take nimble steps, I'll be a David. I'll show Michael twice how he behaved. Come, life, shake your life, come, life eternal. Shake, shake out of me all that is carnal. I'll take nimble steps, I'll be a David. I'll show Michael twice how he behaved. Come, life, shake your life, come, life eternal. Shake, shake out of me all that is carnal. I'll take nimble steps, I'll be a David. I'll show Michael twice how he behaved.
Happy early Thanksgiving to all. I am Rabbi Jill Perlman. I'm one of the rabbis at Temple Isaiah in Lexington, Massachusetts. Temple Isaiah also serves, along with Shalom Emeth, Bedford community. I myself am a Bedford resident. And I am ever so grateful to be able to join with you today as I did last year, especially given the events of this past year. It is wonderful indeed to be able to be together and to live with one another in unity. So I want to take this opportunity with you all here to actually teach you a little bit of Hebrew, if that's okay. Just a tad. I want to teach you the word for turkey. You can repeat after me. Tarnagol. Hodu. It's two words. The word for turkey in Hebrew is two words, tarnagol, hodu. Tarnagol on its own means chicken, and hodu on its own means India. So technically, turkey in Hebrew is chicken of India. Very interesting. I don't know if anyone knew that. I'm sure you knew that. So, of course, this reflects the widespread but entirely incorrect assumption of where these birds actually came from when the word tarnagol hodu came about. There were no turkeys running around in the Holy Land, so we had to come up with a new phrase. So we know it means both, hodu on its own means both India and turkey, and interestingly enough, in Hebrew, it actually has a third meaning. Hodu means thanks or thanksgiving in Hebrew. It's a word that's referenced all throughout our literature, all throughout the book of Psalms, for instance. Psalm 18 says, and we actually saw a piece of that in the hymn that was sung as the clergy walked in, Hodu l'Adonai ki tov, ki le'olam kasto, give thanks to God who is good. God's loving kindness endures. It's particularly interesting that hodu has all of these meanings, especially thanks, gratitude, thanksgiving in turkey as we approach this American holiday of Thanksgiving. It is certainly a season for turkey and a season for gratitude. So let us indeed hodu, let us indeed give praise. I want to invite you all to fill your hearts now with what you are particularly grateful for at this season. And I don't want us to just keep it inside. I want us to share it. So what I want you to do is turn to your left, your right, in front of you, behind you, especially if you turn to someone you might not know as well. And I want you to share that moment of gratitude, that feeling of gratitude. So go ahead, share it. With gratitude on our lips, and with gratitude in our hearts, we say we thank you. We say, Modim Anachnu Lach, God of goodness, we give thanks for the gift of life, wonder beyond words, for the awareness of soul, our light within, for the world around us so filled with beauty, for the richness of the earth, which day by day sustains us. For all these, all that we have shared with one another, for all these and more, we offer thanks. Blessed are you, Source on High, your name is goodness, and you are worthy, indeed, of our thanksgiving and our gratitude. Amen.
Hello, everyone, and happy early Thanksgiving as well to each of you. My name is Rob Worthlin, and I'm a member of the Bedford Clergy Association for the Billerica Congregation of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. And what a pleasure it is for me to be here to represent our congregation. Our congregation draws people from not only Billerica, but Bedford, and many of the other surrounding communities. And so we feel a part of the community here and are grateful that we can be here today. I'm going to share with you some of the things that we are thankful for that in our faith tradition from the canon of Scripture that we enjoy. And I hope that you'll find it as meaningful and uplifting as I do. I'd like to begin with the first Scripture that says, "Thou shalt thank the Lord thy God in all things." Now, this scriptural command is found in what we call the Doctrine and Covenants, part of the canon of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Our prophet, Thomas S. Monson, shared the following insights about a story from the Bible. This is in the book of Matthew, where we have an account of the Savior Jesus Christ. And he said, "As he traveled in the wilderness for 3 days, more than 4,000 people followed and traveled with him. He took compassion on them, for they may not have eaten during the entire 3 days. His disciples, however, questioned, 'Whence should we have so much bread in the wilderness as to fill so great a multitude?' Like many of us, the disciples saw only what was lacking. And Jesus saith unto them, 'How many loaves have ye?' And the disciples said, 7, and a few little fishes. And Jesus commanded the multitude to sit down on the ground. And he took the 7 loaves and the fishes and gave thanks and brake them and gave to his disciples and the disciples to the multitude." Notice that the Savior gave thanks for what they had, and a miracle followed. "And they did all eat and were filled, and they took up of the broken meat that was left 7 baskets full." In the Book of Mormon, we are also taught that we should, quote, "live in thanksgiving daily for the many mercies and blessings which he doth bestow upon you." One way to give thanks to God was taught by another Book of Mormon prophet. King Benjamin, who led the people not only as a spiritual leader, but as the leader of their community and government, taught the following, "And behold, I tell you these things that ye may learn wisdom, that ye may learn that when ye are in the service of your fellow beings, ye are only in the service of your God. Behold, ye have called me to be your king, and if I, whom ye do call your king, do labor to serve you, then ought not ye to labor to serve one another? And behold also, if I, whom ye call your king, who has spent his days in your service, and yet has been in the service of God, do merit any thanks from you, oh, how you ought to thank your heavenly King." Choice blessings await those to live in thanksgiving daily. From the Doctrine and Covenants we read, "He who receiveth all things with thankfulness, the Lord has promised, shall be made glorious, and the things of this earth shall be added unto him, even 100-fold, yea, even more." It is my prayer during this Thanksgiving season that we can look to all things with gratitude. And what a wonderful part of the community that we can be here with our brothers and sisters in faith. And with that greeting and blessing, I say that and wish you the happy Thanksgiving.
Good afternoon. My name is Chris Wendell. I'm the rector of St. Paul's Episcopal Church here in Bedford. It's my great pleasure to be with you this afternoon. I bring with me a brief prayer from the Book of Common Prayer, and I invite you to join me in whatever parts of this prayer reflect the thoughts of your hearts, and the rest of it you can leave to others. O God, who created all peoples in your image, we thank you for the wonderful diversity of races and cultures in this world. Enrich our lives by ever-widening circles of fellowship, and show us your presence in those who differ most from us, until our knowledge of your love is made perfect in our love for all your children. In the name of the Holy and Undivided Trinity, one God in three persons. Amen.
Good afternoon. My name is Megan Lines. I am one of the ministers at the First Parish in Bedford, Unitarian Universalist, just across the common that way. I have to say, this music sounds so good. It's so diverse in its spectrum, and it's just lovely to hear each people, each group, sharing from each of our different faith traditions. It really strikes me as something unique that we, as people of Bedford and surrounding towns, can gather together from so many different traditions and be here honoring the diversity of the world and building the world we dream about together. And it's in that spirit that I've brought a poem. This is a poem written by the Palestinian-American poet Naomi Shihab Nye, and it's called Gate A4. Wandering around the Albuquerque airport terminal after learning my flight had been delayed for 4 hours, I heard an announcement. If anyone in the vicinity of Gate A4 understands any Arabic, please come to the gate immediately. Well, one pauses these days. Gate A4 was my own gate. I went there. An older woman in full traditional Palestinian embroidered dress, just like my grandma wore, was crumpled to the floor, wailing loudly. Help, said the flight service person. Talk to her. What is her problem? We told her the flight was going to be late, and she did this. I stooped to put my arm around the woman and spoke to her haltingly. Shudwa shubdik habibti. Stani shwe min fadlik shubit sui. The minute she heard any words she knew, however poorly used, she stopped crying. She thought the flight had been canceled entirely. She needed to be in El Paso for major medical treatment the next day. I said, no, we're fine. You'll get there, just later. Who's picking you up? Let's call him. We called her son, and I spoke with him in English. I told him I would stay with his mother till we got on the plane and would ride with her right next to her on Southwest. She talked to him. Then we called her other sons just for the fun of it. And then we called my dad, and she spoke to him for a while in Arabic and found out that, of course, they had 10 shared friends. Then I thought that just for the heck of it, why not call some Palestinian poets I know and let them chat with her? This all took up about 2 hours. She was laughing a lot by then, telling about her life, patting my knee, answering questions. She had pulled a sack of homemade mamoul cookies, little powdered sugar, crumbly mounds stuffed with dates and nuts, out of her bag and was offering them to all the women at the gate. To my amazement, not a single woman declined one. It was like a sacrament. The traveler from Argentina, the mom from Florida, the lovely woman from Laredo, we were all covered with the same powdered sugar. And smiling, there is no better cookie. And then the airline broke out free beverages from huge coolers, and two little girls from our flight ran around serving us all apple juice, and they were covered with powdered sugar too. And I noticed my new best friend. By now we were holding hands. She had a potted plant poking out of her bag, some medicinal thing with green furry leaves. Such an old country tradition. Always carry a plant. Always stay rooted to somewhere. And I looked around that gate of late and weary ones, and I thought, this is the world I want to live in. The shared world. Not a single person in that gate, once the crying of confusion stopped, seemed apprehensive about any other person. They took the cookies. I wanted to hug all those other women, too. This can still happen anywhere, like here. Not all is lost.
Shalom. I'm Rabbi Susan Abramson. I'm the rabbi at Temple Shalom Emeth in Burlington and a longtime Bedford resident, and I'm grateful to be a member of this community. I'm grateful for the way in which everybody has risen to the occasion and been so supportive of the Jewish community and all of those who felt estranged or threatened in this past year. We continue with a litany of gratitude for our diversity in the middle of your pamphlets. On this day of National Thanksgiving, we are grateful to God not only for those benefits that have come to us from this land and from our experience of its settlement and development, but also for the gifts that the settlers in this country brought with them from their lands of origin. For we are the children of many nations, bound together by all that is good in many heritages and cultures. Together, those who have here sought a haven and refuge, from the first settlers in Jamestown and at Plymouth Rock to those who still enter our country from many lands, came not empty-handed, but bearing many cultural gifts. We are grateful for the gifts brought to this country by the sturdy stock that came from England, for their gift of the language we speak, for their gift of civic liberty, and for the freedom of worship they planted and fostered in this land. But not from England alone stem those blessings that make us thank you for having cast our lot in this blessed land. The pattern of America is a blend of culture from many lands, woven threads from many corners of the world. Diversity itself is the pattern of America, the very stuff and color of its fabric. To reap the full benefits of that diversity, we should seek to know more about the experiences and qualities, hopes and achievements of the many kinds of people who make America. Not until wave after wave of these facts sweep over us will the true quality of our American life ring in the American atmosphere, the American consciousness. Only then will all Americans feel themselves at one with the builders of America in the past and with each other in the present, drawn together, knit together by a common stake in America. Then all over this country, Americans will feel themselves at home in the history of America, in that interplay, that diversity, which is America. The cultural atmosphere of the United States will mean new and broader ways of seeing our neighbors and freer and more generous ways of behaving towards them. It will mean a new solidarity, irrespective of background, one that lets people remain themselves. It will bring into full play the health, simultaneous tension, and fusion of stubborn, creative differences, challenging all groups and individuals to work with one another in contributing from their own life to the good of all. Open our eyes, O God, that we may see your divine image in all and accept humbly and gratefully the gifts that each race, creed, and nationality brings to our American life. Amen.
Certainly been a joy to hear everybody share their music and their praise, their songs, their prayers. I'll be reading from Paul's letter, first letter to Timothy, but before I do, I'm Scott Arnold. I'm the pastor at First Baptist Church here in Bedford. But here are these words from the Apostle Paul as they speak to this matter of coming together for prayer, for thanksgiving. Second chapter, first verse. I urge then, first of all, that requests, prayers, intercessions, and thanksgiving be made for everyone. Let me repeat that. That requests, prayers, intercession, and thanksgiving be made for everyone. For kings, and all those in authority, that we may live peaceful and quiet lives in all godliness and holiness. This is good and pleases God our Savior, who wants all mankind to be saved and to come to a knowledge of the truth. And I think that's something we could all agree upon. But the Apostle Paul was one whose life had been changed by an encounter. And he wrote further, "For there is one God and one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself as a ransom for all people, the testimony given in its proper time. And for this purpose, I was appointed a herald and an apostle. I am telling the truth. I am not lying. And a teacher of the true faith to the Gentiles." My life is one that has been changed because of an encounter I had. And people have different encounters with the living God. But I can tell you from my own personal experience, having encountered Jesus Christ at a time that I had cancer, him coming to me and bringing healing to me, that I believe he is the mediator between God and mankind. We all seek the truth. And this gathering is one where we seek to understand one another and our differences. But we should always pray for each one in our community, for everyone. And we should give thanksgiving for the blessings that are abundant to all human beings. For we are all made in the image of God. And as we journey in this life, let us seek that which is right, true, good, and be gracious and merciful to one another. May the peace of Christ and of God, our gracious Creator, Redeemer, be with you.
Thank you. drummer, huh?
Let us join together in the closing prayer printed in your bulletin. Holy God, we rejoice in your greatness and power, your gentleness and love, your mercy and justice. Enable us by your Spirit to honor your thoughts, in our words, and in our actions, to serve you in every aspect of our lives. Amen. Let us all together rise and sing hymn number 22, Let All Things Now Living. Now let us depart with hearts full of gratitude, with eyes open to see the abundant blessings that God pours into our lives every day. And may the grace and mercy of our God, most compassionate, be and dwell with us this day and forevermore. Amen. Let us join together in a congregational blessing, number 714 in your hymnal.
Shalom, 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 sh
There is a reception over the side. Please come to the reception on the side room.
Feel free to join us for a reception right through this door.